In today's lecture, we are going to see cost of quality and value of quality. So, these quality losses occurring in any manufacturing industry, there are some many causes, that is selection of poor input, selection of poor technology or poor product design. So, if you see broadly, the cost of quality is divided into four costs. These are the four costs in which the cost of quality of any product is divided. So today we are going to see this one by one. So first one is a prevention cost. This prevention cost is whenever we are manufacturing any product, first we are making the planning. So this prevention cost include the quality planning of a product, then documenting, various document we have to create for that product, then training given to the employer about that product, and planning of a process control, means how we are going to doing the processes. So that planning also include in a prevention cost. Then preventive maintenance, before the machine or any product get into a breakage, before that we are doing a preventive maintenance. That preventive maintenance is coming under this prevention cost. So if we consider the cost of quality as 100%, if we are getting a cost of quality as 100%, in that percentage this prevention cost included 10%. Next is the appraisal cost, in which it includes inspection, that is in raw material we are getting, that raw material inspection, then in process inspection, and after the process is completed, the quality check inspection, that comes under inspection, then testing, that destructive test we are carrying out, that comes under this appraisal cost, then maintenance of any machine, then quality audits, calibration of any instrument, that measuring instrument which we are using for measuring the dimension of the part which we are produced. To get that dimension properly, we are going to calibrate that instrument. So this is a calibration. Then registration cost, if we are getting a part which is newly manufactured, then for registration we are getting some cost. All these costs are coming under this appraisal cost, and this appraisal cost is getting 40% from the cost of quality. Then remaining is a failure cost. This failure cost can be of two types, that is internal failure cost, means the failure occurred in a industry whenever they are manufacturing the part, and second one is the external failure cost. Once the product is manufactured, when it is dispatched to the customer, that at the customer level we are getting some failure, and that includes in a external failure cost. Among these, this failure cost contains the 50% of overall cost of quality. So internal failure cost is a process delay. So we are getting some product to be manufactured within stipulated time. If the product is not manufactured that time due to some process delay, so that comes under internal failure cost. Then rework, if the part is not manufactured with the proper dimension, then we are going to do the rework, that is remachining. Then if the part is a defective, then we have to scrap it. Destructive test we are getting, if you want to validate or retest that, then that comes under internal failure. Then downtime, if the sudden failure of the machine due to some maintenance is taking place, then that is a downtime. Then loss of capacity, if the parts which are producing which are not coming, inventory is not proper, then that is the loss of capacity. So these all are coming under internal failure cost. which is whenever they are manufactured in a industry. Then external failure cost, if the product is manufactured, then we are going to dispatch to the customer. At the customer level, this failure occur, that if some part is not as per the requirement to the customer, so the customer will return that part, so that is a customer returns. Warranty, if the part is coming under warranty and if the failure is occur, then we are giving some service to that part, so that warranty it is bear by the manufacturer. Then loss of customer sales, if the part is coming into the market, if that part is not sold properly, then the sales which are lost, that will be the external failure. Then sort and repair at the customer, the maintenance we are getting, that it is the repairing of a part which is dispatched to the customer. And lower quality stores, if we are manufacture the product in a huge quantity and if we are stored in a wrong way, then there is a possibility that some part will wear out or some defective is produced. So if you are not stored properly, then that will include the external failure cost. So these are the four costs which come under to get a quality product. This, the prevention cost and appraisal cost is a cost of good quality. It is a cost of good quality. When we want to produce a good product and we have to provide to the customer. And this internal failure cost and external failure cost is a cost of bad quality. Cost of bad quality. Among these, if you want to get a proper quality product which is having a zero defect, so we have to spend some more attention on a prevention cost, and this will bear by the company. And this internal failure cost and external failure cost and appraisal cost which are given to the customer, so that will be minimized if you are spending more attention on this prevention cost. So if we consider these four costs with respect to the total quality cost we are getting, so if you draw one graph based on the quality level which are getting for the product from the 0 to 100%, means 100% means 100% quality level, that is zero defects. If you plot a graph, that is cost per good quality of product versus quality level, in traditional outlook we are getting some optimum quality level, that every industry without taking a quality measures, if you plot this graph, the total quality cost we are getting at a optimum quality level. So here we are not focusing on 100% quality level, we are getting some amount that we are getting some gap here. So we are not getting a optimum quality level at 100%. So this is a total cost of quality, in which this is a traditional outlook, we are not focusing on a quality measures. So this is internal failure cost and prevention and appraisal cost. Based on that, the 100% defects is not up getting, some defects will be produced in the product, that is a traditional. If we are focusing on the zero defects, if you minimize the zero defects at a 100% quality level, the new cost per good unit of product versus quality level graph we are getting in this, where we are measuring the quality of that product based on the cost, then the optimum level quality level we are getting at a 100%, where we are minimizing the zero effect. So if we are getting this optimum quality level at a 100%, then the sales of a company can be increased and its reputation to the market for that product, it will increase. So we can see that the total quality cost also goes on decline if we are maintaining the 100%. Here the total quality cost we are getting at some optimum level, that is it is a minimum total cost in a traditional look, and this is the minimum total cost. So here you can see the minimum total cost is getting lower if we are maintaining the 100% quality level with a zero defects. Then next graph is showing based on the failure cost and time when failure found. So it is a quality cost increase over time. So if sometimes the failure found at certain level, so that failure will give the cost to the product. So this is the graph from the low to high for the quality failure cost versus time. Then in the prevention cost, if the failure occur at a low level, then the failure cost will be lower. If the failure we are getting when we are getting the final product which is manufactured, at that time the failure cost goes on increasing. That is prevention cost, it will be less. Then it goes on increasing, that failure found it during design phase, failure found at onset of manufacturing when we are doing the manufacturing, failure found at a inspection of a product, and if we are installing that product at some assembly, if there the failure found, then the failure cost will increase. If the product is manufacturing sale to the customer for the repairing, that on-field repairing, then the failure cost will increase. And failure found by the customer, if the customer return that product, then that failure cost goes on increasing. And liability cost, the reputation of the company will decrease and it will decrease the sales to the product. So we have to focus on this prevention cost so that all other costs can be reduced. So that is regarding the cost of quality. Then next is a value of quality. So this value of quality is a direct or indirect return or gain to the manufacturer because of a quality mission. So if we minimize the cost of quality and if we provide the 100% quality level product with a zero defect, then we are getting some return to the manufacturer, and this return can be as terms of increasing the sales. So that will give the value of quality. So this value of quality is an addition of quality of design and quality of conformance. So if you are focusing on quality of design and quality of conformance, then that value of quality will increase. As we seen, the cost of quality can be measured with some quantity, but value of quantity cannot be measured directly. It can be estimated with some features. So these features are sales we are getting in an increase, because of that we can measure the value of quality. Features of design, the features how we are providing with a opponent product, that will increase your value of quality. How simple is your product, the reduction in the complexity, that will increase. Then ease of operation, how easily the operation is performed on that product. The interchangeability of parts, means how the parts are available if the part we want to change in the assembly. Then life of a product, how long the product will operate easily and satisfactorily. The life goes on increasing, then that value of product will increase, and that will increase the value of quality. Then capacity to take overload. So whatever the product we are manufactured, it should take the maximum load to perform its operation. Then reliability, how anyone can reliable on that product too while doing the operation. Then reputation of the manufacturers and cost. So this reputation, if the reputation of a manufacturer is developed in the market based on this value of quality, then sales of the product will increase and it will give some return to the manufacturer, and it that will based on the value of quality. So in today's lecture we have seen cost of quality and value of quality, the relation how we are getting. So if you like this video, please subscribe my channel Engineering Fundamental. Also stay connected. If you like it, press the like button, comment, share. Thank you.